Kabuji kuhelani. Tulaka tubusha.
I'm in.
Unuratu just left with Hakan. She'll be ready when you open the gate.
Kale, ya no te anta la sultal de tel o kila el kiko. O el kila, shena chava, malo bulat.
On the right track.
Palchuco so okwautan
tak bela ma mauka tuyal tuskutaki kuba le kushimakobo
oksahola le nono vale misbalu belal yankoksik tuyole kukulkan le bejo
minha minma
ha
ya ningwili kwa misbal.
Lejé la maustintan.
This looks like the right place. There's the gate I need to open. To open that gate. Impossible. I can't carry anymore.
Shokol! Galantville!
Mother! Would you get him out of here? Jonah.
How's Edsley?
Fine. They got him out, but Unaratu was captured.
Oh no. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm going after the box. I don't know how long it'll take.
Do what you have to.
Thanks. The Eye of the Serpent. That's it. I got Unaratu captured. What's Dominguez gonna do with her? As long as he needs the box, he'll keep her alive. I hope. 26th of November, 1603. At dinner, Lopez asked me if I believed these heathens were worthy of the artifact's alleged power. I had to admit that the Paititians seemed noble and industrious. However, their taut skin stretched tight over sinewy muscles, and lack of shame made them more similar to beasts. And what of our leaders in the society? He then asked. Should they be able to wave their perfumed and ring fingers in any direction and expect us to obey, to return and sit at their side when they beckon? Do they not treat us as inferior beings, as beasts as well? I had no answer. What he'd said was heresy and treason, but in some way, I wondered if it wasn't the truth. These things. It's not Maya or Inca. That I could dive. All right, here I go. This is incredible. Thank you. Another example of syncretic belief. This figure portrayed on the cross is not Jesus Christ, but Kukulkan. I suppose a parallel could be drawn between the two. The detailed engravings on this helmet, in its unusually good condition, could mean this helmet was worn more as an accessory, rather than protection in combat. Perhaps Lopez used it to project an air of importance. A rubbing taken from the walls of the cenote. It is simply a large X and the word run.
Thank you.
1st of December, 1603. We've entered a cenote not far from the city and set up camp in a small alcove. Lopez has spent the evening staring into the flames, utterly ensorcelled, his dinner untouched. Twice I attempted a conversation, but his silence rebuffed me each time. He is utterly focused on this artifact. If I were a more superstitious man, I would wonder if the artifact is speaking to him directly. The soldiers keep to themselves as well. They seem anxious for battle. One of their dogs stared at me all evening, as though I were to be his next meal.
Thank you.
There must have been an incredible battle here. This seems to be some kind of primitive sculpture of a human. Inside this cavern. Even rusted out, you can tell this is a quality weapon. It was likely manufactured in Toledo. The city was renowned for their steelwork. The notches on the blade suggest several battles. Thank you. Swung out too far to reach. All full up. Can't carry any more. We underestimated the natives, crafty bastards. Told us of a cave filled with gold, but they led us into a trap. The damn place was filled with monsters. After a ferocious battle, we pushed them back. The remaining men loaded the ship with whatever valuables we could find. The battle must have weakened the cavern, for when we tried to escape, it collapsed. I hear them out there, even now, digging through the barriers.
Thank you.
to abandon ship. Just a noise.
Huh.
These must be the Triti soldiers who went missing.
Time to move.
Thank you.
This rosary has 6 decades instead of the usual 5. A very ornate example of the Brigantine version. There appears to be an engraving. Andreas Lopez. Dated. Strange warriors pursued us through the caverns. We moved quickly, too quickly for an accurate description. Most of the soldiers fell in battle. They were valiant, but outmatched and outnumbered. Eventually, Lopez, I, and a single surviving soldier reached a magnificent temple. I cannot imagine how the people managed to build such a structure so deep underground. A massive door blocked our progress. Lopez, his voice frantic and breaking, ordered Perez, the last remaining conquistador, to stand guard while we worked on the mechanism. The door began to roll open. Our celebration of success was drastically cut short by the dying screams of Perez. The sound haunts me still. First of December, 1603. A strange noise woke me in the middle of the night. I found Lopez still staring at the fire, though now it was nothing but coals. I asked him if he'd heard the noise as well, but all he did was grunt. I wrapped a blanket about his shoulders and built up the fire again. Then I sat and listened. Far off shrieks and hisses, likely distorted by the twists of the caverns. But underneath all those sounds, I heard a faint thrum. I've heard something like that before, but rarely, and only when in the deepest of prayers. It sounded like the voice of God. Look at all this. What's behind that door? All right.
Thank you. Shabak.